How's it going, everyone? Maximilian here, back with the final changelog video for Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 on the Marvel side of the cast. So let's get this thing started and cover the remaining four characters. First up, MODOK. So MODOK has probably changed the least of almost any character in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 compared to the vanilla side of the cast. His changelog literally only highlights one significant adjustment, and it's that his jump attacks can now be cancelled by air dashes. So MODOK players might have to make a little bit of adjustments to some of their combos because of the new hit damage and hit stun scaling, but I'm not too proficient with MODOK play in any way whatsoever to offer much of an opinion other than to show you guys how this air dash cancelling works and some potential that it could have for mix-ups or air combos. But jump attacks that can be cancelled by air dashes is the only thing that MODOK got in Ultimate. Next up is one of the most powerful characters in the original game, and it's Wolverine. So Wolverine's dive kick and jumping light hitboxes have been reduced. I feel the dive kick won quite a bit, and the jumping light still is effective for getting overheads and going into combos, but on bigger characters especially, it's kinda hard to tell. The invincibility during Berserker Slash has been removed, and you can see on the screen here that that changes a lot as far as how Wolverine will get around with his mix-ups on the ground. Berserker Rage was formerly known as Swiss Cheese, and this move is extra goofy. It might remove a lot of the damage from your combos because it causes a lot of hits really fast. Berserker Charge Command Input Priority changed to the lowest among hyper combos, so I think this means that when it combats against other hyper combos at the same time, Berserker Charge won't get the priority. I'm not too sure because I didn't play a lot of Wolverine and I didn't run into this issue, but yeah, Berserker Charge was a very good move and they're trying to make it not as good in this one. Next up is Thor, and this big guy got quite a few changes. He got reduced pushback for his standing medium. The hitboxes for light and the jumping light version of Mighty Spark have been enlarged slightly, and this is before the beam comes out. There was also increased minimum damage scaling on his normals and specials, and the opponent's untackable time after Mighty Spark was also increased. There's less time needed to fully charge the heavy Mighty Smash now, and the total frames for Mighty Strike have also been reduced. There's also less time needed to fully charge the Mighty Strike as well. Also, active throw frames for Mighty Hurricane have also been increased for all of the strengths, and Mighty Punish got one frame of invincibility, so it's actually a really good single frame grabbing hyper now. There's also increased advantage time off Mighty Punish, and the active throw frames of Mighty Punish were also increased as well, so that super got a lot better than the original game. Next up is one of the more awkward characters from the vanilla roster, and it's Shuma Gorath. Shuma is also one of the characters to get very few changes made. His jumping special is now untechable, but they removed the off-the-ground property, so that didn't mean too much because you hardly used it in the original. For normal throws, not only health, but hyper combo gauge is absorbed, so if you see here, it takes around 4 complete throws to suck a single hyper meter from the opponent. Devitalization comes out faster as well for his command throws, and that's about it on his end. Shuma Gorath still seems really intact in this game. And that just about does it for the entire Marvel side of the roster from the vanilla Marvel vs. Capcom 3. We're going to be diving into the Capcom characters very soon, but there's another video I wanted to share with you guys highlighting the effect of mashing hypers specifically. You might notice we didn't cover that in these videos, and that's because I wanted to put it all into one place. So look forward to a Marvel side of the cast mashing hypers video where I can show you exactly what mashing does in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.